Hello everyone, it is Vasimadhav here and welcome to Dope Science. Today, I'm going to talk about an extremely sad topic. And that topic is, why is male fertility declining? So, let's start the intro.
Across the globe are becoming increasingly less fertile. Scientists are predicting sperm counts reaching zero by 2045.
The first thing I'm going to talk about is, what is happening? According to our research, in 1973, a teaspoon of sperms had 99 million viable sperms. However, in 2011, that number went down to 47 million viable sperms. Keep in mind that when a person hits the 40 million mark, then that person will start to face some fertility issues. Also, our testosterone levels have been declining since 1982. The research shows that from 1973 to 2011, sperm count has declined by 59%. Sperm count is the amount of sperm in a milliliter of semen. Now, you might be thinking, what are the cons of having lower sperm count? And the answer is, lower sperm counts make you more vulnerable to testicular cancer and you are less likely to reproduce.
Not only are we seeing lower sperm count, but also shrinking penises and shrinking taint, or the distance between the anus and the genitals. Moreover, 26% of men under the age of 40 face erectile dysfunction. Today, men's fertility issues contribute to one-third of all fertility issues.
The alarming thing is that the decline in sperm count is not slowing down. And according to an estimate, by 2045, the sperm count will fall down to zero in men. Now, let's talk about why is this happening. A lot of things play a role in declining the sperm count. Nonetheless, let's start with three main things: plastics, pesticides, and chemicals in everyday products. These things contain EDCs, or endocrine disrupting chemicals. EDCs bind to hormone sites in our body and fool our body into thinking that they are the real hormones. Furthermore, they also control how our hormones are broken down and stored. As a matter of fact, they also control our body's sensitivity to the real hormones. Therefore, EDCs negatively affect the reproductive system as well as other biological systems like immunological, neurological, metabolic, and cardiovascular systems. These EDCs enter our body through food, drinks, microscopic airborne particles, and the products we use on our skins.
Phthalates, a type of EDC, are found in plastics, floor coverings, wall coverings, hairsprays, and soaps. Almost one-third of the household items have phthalates in them. If an expected mother is exposed to phthalates between week 8 and week 12 of the embryo's development, then her son is going to have a small penis and lower sperm count. This happens because phthalates trick our body into thinking that it has more testosterone than it actually does, which causes the body to stop producing testosterone, and that leads to lower sperm count.
Another type of EDC is called BPA. It is present in plastics, electronics, receipt papers, and non-stick coatings.
In factories with high BPA, most workers had 4 times lower sperm count, 3 times lower sperm vitality, and decreased sperm mobility.
Not to mention, but the sons of these workers had less sexual desire.
Similarly, there are many more chemicals which lead to lower sperm count, small penises, and small taint.
There are other things which too play a role in decreasing the sperm count. For example, smoking cigarettes and marijuana damages sperms and decreases testosterone levels. Likewise, men who ate more processed food had lower sperm count and less normally shaped semen. The reason behind it is that chemicals and meat in processed food cause endocrine issues.
According to some studies, stressed and obese men had lower sperm count too. To some extent, climate change also plays a role in decreasing the sperm count.
I know this is bizarre, but it is true.
Look, in males, testes are hanging outside of the body because this way their temperature will be less than the body's temperature. Now, if the atmospheric temperature will rise, then temperature of the testes will also rise, resulting in lower sperm count.
Now we know why everything is happening, let's talk about the solution.
Try to eat less meat and dairy, and do not heat food in plastic containers. Doing so will pollute your food with chemicals that are present in plastic containers. Also, try to avoid eating out because the packaging and the gloves used by fast food workers can release chemicals into your food. One study found out that teenagers who ate out more had 55% more EDCs in their bodies compared to teenagers who mostly ate at home.
Try to use nonstick pans at lower heat. If possible, get rid of them. And if possible, try to eat less processed foods because the packaging and the food manufacturing can cause EDCs to enter your food. Moreover, governments all around the world must regulate corporations from using these chemicals on us. Please try to control the decline in sperm count before it is too late. I hope you got valuable information from this video. Please share this video with as many people as possible, so together we can spread awareness around the world and help our species to thrive in the future. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.